Hello children, let's start with chapter number 4. This is the first chapter of the first term, that's control anger before it controls us. To begin with, we have certain brainstorming questions. Now for these questions, you have to give your own answer, like what you think about it. You have to answer maybe yes, no or don't know. Then again, there is a anger map. There are 6 questions. You try to answer it on your own only and see where does your anger reaches. Now we'll start with the story, lasting effects of bad temper. Now this is a story about a man and his son who had a very bad temper. So the father gave this boy a bag of nails and told that whenever he loses his temper, he should put a nail or hammer a nail in the back of the fence. On the starting day, the boy noticed that he had driven 12 nails into the fence. And now, slowly he started controlling his anger. So the number of nails he used to hammer also decreased. And he discovered, like he found out that controlling the anger was comparatively easy rather than hammering the nails into the fence. Then finally, one day the boy did not lose the temper at all. He told his father about the whole thing, how he started and where he reached. And father now suggested that you should now start taking out the nails, and for every time he was able to control his temper, he should take out one nail from the fence. Now as the days passed, the boy was finally able to take out all the nails, and he told the father about it, and the father said, like, it's very nice that you have done, you have taken out all the nails, but just see the fence very carefully. And when he noticed that on that fence, all those signs of the hammering of the nails were there. Like all the nails were taken out, but he could see the impression of the nails onto the fence. Now this actually means that we say something in anger, but later on when we repent about it, the mark of that anger still remains. So we should always control before we speak something. Now we will read out. When we say something in anger, it hurts others and leaves a wound, a verbal wound, which is as bad as a physical wound. So the friends and the loved ones who are very close to us, they are very precious to us because they encourage us, they make us smile, or they help us in succeeding. So we should always water our relationship with kindness. We should not say something that harms the relation, or we should not chase them away with the bad things that we say to them. Now we have certain points how we can control our anger, and point number one is we should think before we speak. So before we speak, we should think number of times what we are going to speak. Be calm before expressing. Now before we start expressing, we should be very calm before getting angry at certain things. We should think about it. We should be calm. We should express our concerns and the needs clearly and directly. And we should think that we should not hurt others in any case. We should get some exercise, like in case we get angry, we should get involved in certain sort of exercise or physical activity, like walking, running, or spending some time. Then taking the time out. We should take short breaks in a day if we are a little stressful, or we can be a little quiet for a moment. Then identify the possible solutions, try to work on the possible solutions that can overcome that anger. We should not hold a grudge if we are angry on someone. We should not hold it. We should try to cover it with the positive feelings. And certain relaxing exercises should be practiced, like breathing exercises, like deep breathing exercises, listening to music, writing a diary, or doing certain sorts of yogas. On this page, he who angers you controls you. Yes, I totally agree that somebody who's able to make us angry is actually controlling us. Now, what is the message? Now, here you can give your own answer also. Like we should not speak wrong to others because we give them a wound which cannot be later on repaired. And how does anger affect the friendship? It chases the friendship away if we say something in anger to our loved ones. and different relaxation skills. We have just now read like deep breathing exercises, listening to music, writing a diary, and doing few yoga poses. Now there is a question here. Recall a situation where you became angry and how did you evaluate your behavior? So work on it and try to write this answer on your own. Thank you, children. With this chapter gets over.